Hello and welcome and in today's episode, Low Landing Attraction in Dam Tro Beach in Côn Đảo. Vietnam first ever sleepless city officially opens. And Vietnamese authorities launch effort to boost the tourism with Quảng Bình to open a new pedestrian zone and Đà Nẵng to build a new swear center to improve and upgrade the infrastructure and services to cope with the new surge of tourists. So let's get moving. Hello, my name is Trang, and if you don't know me yet, I'm from Dương Global's communication team, and you're watching Vietnam Weekly News, where we report and tell you about the stories happening in Vietnam at the moment. And if you like it, please make sure that you hit like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. Thank you. Many people come to Đầm Trồ Beach just to take picture of low landing plants above the beach, lying about 14 kilometers north of the center of Côn Sơn Island. Đầm Trồ Beach is a famous bathing spot for international and domestic visitors who want to come in and enjoy the beach. Recently, it was named amongst 25 most beautiful beaches in the world based on a New York magazine, Travel Plus Leisure magazine. The beach is located right next to the runway of Cả Ống Airport, officially named Côn Đảo Airport, where all flights land on the island. Therefore, visitors standing on the beach can clearly spot plants appearing bigger and bigger, lying right above their head as they land. The way to land at the airport is only 1,800 meters long, only serving short-range aircraft such as ATR. So far, only one airline in Vietnam is allowed to operate flights to Côn Đảo, which is Vasco, operating under the supervision of Vietnam Airlines. Every day, there are a total of about 21 flights from Saigon or Cần Thơ to Côn Đảo. As mentioned in the previous episode, Vietnam is focusing on the nighttime economic development with efforts being made in Đà Nẵng and Phú Quốc, two of the biggest tourist attractions in Vietnam. Last week on April 21, Phú Quốc United Center, a Southeast Asia leading entertainment complex, was created by Vingroup, was officially launched, marking it as Vietnam's first ever sleepless city. Phú Quốc United Center is considered as the first travel entertainment universe in Vietnam that can be compared to all the top attractions such as Jeju, Korea, Black Quay, Singapore, Las Vegas in USA. Moreover, it was also announced by the Vietnam Record Organization to achieve 5 national records. In particular, the record of Vietnam's largest complex with diverse entertainment and resort forms. The remaining 4 records were awarded for 2 work items and 2 art programs, including Vietnam's largest bamboo house and teddy bear museum, the first teddy bear exhibition in Vietnam, 3D multimedia show with the most Vietnamese historical reference, Vietnam's largest floating multimedia show inspired by European culture. Last but not least, an update on Vietnam tourism activities with Quảng Bình to open a new pedestrian street for tourism and Quảng Nam investing in a new central square to attract international and domestic visitors. Quảng Bình, a popular tourist attraction and home to UNESCO heritage Phong Nha Kẻ Bàng National Park, is preparing to open a pedestrian street. Quảng Bình Tourism Department said Đồng Hới City People's Committee, Quảng Bình Province, has just opened and put into operation the pedestrian street for tourism. Accordingly, the pedestrian street was built between two roads, Phan Bội Châu in Đông Hải Ward and Đông Hải Street, Hải Thanh Ward, Đồng Hới City. The street will open from 18 hours to 24 hours on every Fridays, Saturdays, Sundays, on public holidays and at New Year Eve. This is considered a new night tourism product of Đồng Hới City in general and Quảng Bình in particular, and in the form of slow tourism. The goal of the pedestrian street is to meet the needs of entertainment, shopping, enjoy community cultural exchanges, culinary exploration, supplementing tourism products, and attractive night cultural activities. At the same time, contributing to create economic resources for residential communities, creating jobs for local people, and promote trade and service activity in Đồng Hới City. On the same note, Đà Nẵng is also planning to invest in a new central square. After more than 20 years of developing the city, it still not have a worthy central square, which is the home of community activities and tourism activities. Đà Nẵng City authorities said that a new central square will be formed in a prime area around the relic of Điện Hải, Hải Châu. It is expected that by June 2021, Đà Nẵng will host a design contest for the central square. Once completed, the new central square would be built as an iconic public space for visitors and urban showcase of Đà Nẵng's identity. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like it, make sure that you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more. Thank you, and I see you in the next video. Goodbye.